OLA from Department of Agri-Education. Introduction. Animal rearing has been an age-long activity that man had carried out basically for the production of food. And when I mean food, in this case, I mean food of animal origin, such as meat, milk, and eggs. And also involved in the production of raw materials, such as wool, feather, fur, hide and skin, blood, hooves, horn, bone, etc., which are used for agro industries, used as raw materials for agro industries. Apart from being the source of food, which we refer to animal protein, it is generally known all over the world, especially among the less developed countries, that animal production is among the important source or the major source of employment of labor. In Nigeria especially, the rapid growth of other sectors, animal production still retains its leading position as non-ruminant and ruminant alike are used to satisfy and the animal protein needs of man. Definition. Animal science is a branch of agriculture that deals with the scientific study of farm animals and their management. Animal science is also concerned with the science of producing domestic livestock species, including cattle, horses, poultry, sheep, goats, and pigs. Animal science is concerned with food of animal origin, such as meat, dairy, and eggs. The food industry is obviously one of the largest and most important industries in Nigeria. In addition, animal science can also set to be concerned with the aspects of companion animals, including their nutrition, care, and welfare. An animal scientist applies principles of the biological, physical, and social sciences to the problems associated with livestock production and management. Brief history of animal production. Before the invention of agri, man survived on hunting of wildlife animals, gathering of edible fruits. Archaeological evidence shows that the study of human activity through the recovery and analysis of material culture showed that animal domestication started before 7000 BC. While keeping sheep, wild ox, and wheat cultivations were practiced since 9800 BC in Kurdistan. In man's renewed attitude, captured animals were tended through proper feeding, medication, breeding, and application of other management practices, which have led to favorable adaptation and multiplication within the human environment. As man further realized the importance of animal as source of food, which include meat, milk, and eggs, and income, greater attention and efforts were made to improve production and productivity of animals. Now look at the roles of livestock production. 1. Livestock production serve as source of food mainly for the production of animal proteins, which include mainly meat, milk, and eggs. It's also a source of income, can be a source of employment. They are livestock production source of foreign exchange earning, sources of transportation. It can also be used as sources of fuel, sources of organic matter, sources of farm power. There are sources of industrial raw materials. There are sources of entertainment, recreation, and sport. There are sources of educational and scientific research materials. There are also sources of insurance, and also can be used for festivities. They are also used for festival activities. What are the problems of animal production? Problems of animal production include inadequate feed, inadequate capital, land tenure system, inadequate personnel, poor marketing system, environmental pollution, low investment potential, inadequate storage facilities, unstable government policies, poor transportation network, inadequate breeding program, parasites and disease infestation, and also inadequate processing and preservation facilities. Classification of farm animals. Classification is the process of grouping, sorting, and arranging farm animals into categories. Farm animals are classified mainly based on stomach structure. There are two groups of farm animals. One, the ruminants, which are also known as the polygastric animals. These are mammals that belong to the order Artiodactyla. They have complex stomachs, unlike the non-ruminant that have simple stomachs. Ruminants eat and digest forages or plant-based feed by swallowing it first and allow it to get moisting in the rumen, which is the first compartment of the complex stomach. The swallowed food is later regurgitated by the animal and rechewed to break down the plant material for digestion. This process is called rumination or chewing the cud. Two, non-ruminant or monogastric animals. Non-ruminants are animals that have simple stomach. They possess no rumen, reticulum, and omasum. Non-ruminants cannot on their own produce enzymes that digest cellulose, and they do not chew the cud like their ruminant counterparts. Some of them, which includes rabbits, exhibit a behavioral specialization called coprophagy or psychotrophy, that is the act of eating soft feces directly from the anus, which aid digestion of fiber. However, prevention of such act results in rapid deficiencies of vitamin K, biotin, and other vitamins. It also reduces the growth rate by 15% of the animal's abnormal growth and decreases food digestibility, protein utilization, and nitrogen retention in affected animals. Examples are pig, poultry, and rabbit. Farm animals can also be classified based on purpose of production. Based on purpose of production, animals can be categorized or classified into one, beef or meat type. These are animals that are kept primarily for the production of meat, such as beef cattle, sheep, goat, pig, rabbits, and broilers. Second classification under purpose of production is the dairy type. These are animals kept primarily for milk production, e.g., we have dairy cows, dairy cattle, majorly dairy cattle. We also have the work draft and type. These are animals that are kept primarily for farm power, such as bulls, majorly bulls, egg-laying cattle. These are animals that are cared primarily for egg production, and this is excluded to majorly poultry. I mean, this is peculiar to layers in poultry production. Animals or livestock can also be classified based on type of food or feed eating. There are four groups of animals here, mainly one, herbivores. These are animals that feed on plant material. Example are cattle, camel, sheep, and goat. The second classification is based on animals that feed on meat, and they are known as carnivorous animals. Third classification is omnivores. These are animals that feed on both plants and animals. Example is the pig. And then we have insectivores. These are animals that feed on insects. Example is poultry. Breeds of farm animals. Breeds can be defined as a group of animals that are related, that is, they have having the same ancestor, appearance, conformation, size, and other notable and distinguishing features, or a group of animals that are distinguishable from other groups with regard to some characteristics that are generally genetically determined. Number one, cattle. Cattle belongs to the family Bovidae and are subdivided into two groups, namely Bos indicus, secondly Bos taurus. Bos indicus refers to the breed of cattle found mostly in the tropics, and they possess hump. Example of these Bos indicus breeds under Bos indicus are Bonaji, Rahaji, Sokoto Gudali, Adamawa Gudali, Keteku, Wadara, Kuri, Ndama, and Muturu. The second classification under this family is Bos taurus, and these strains do not possess horns and are found in the temperate regions of the world. Examples are the Holstein Friesian, the Ayrshire, the Jersey, the Hereford, the Brahman, the Swiss Brown, the Aberdeen, the Angus, etc. For sheep, breeds of sheep that are indigenous to Nigeria are 1. Uda, 2. Balami, 3. Yankasa, 4. West African Dwarf. Breeds of goats involve Sokoto Red, Sahelian Goat, and the West African Dwarf. The breed of pig involve Landrace, Hampshire, Duroc, Large White, Tamworth, Chester White, Yorkshire, and Ashanti Dwarf. Breed of rabbit involve Angora, the Crosses, the Dutch, the English Spots, the Flemish Giant, Chinchilla, Californian White, Rahaji, and New Zealand White, New Zealand Red. Breeds of poultry includes Anak, Ancona, Sussex, Leghorn, the Shika Brown, the Black Hakolea, the Plymouth, the Rhode Island Red, also the New Hampshire. Just some examples of the different types of breed for the different livestock animals that different livestock will have. Next, we go to management system of farm animals. Management system refers to different ways of rearing farm animals. There are three major management systems in Nigeria, and they include 1, the extensive system, 2, the intensive system, or what we refer to as the modern system, then the semi-intensive system. the extensive system and just keeping of animals in the open range. The animals are left to search for feed on their own while they come back at night to sleep under any available shed. In Nigeria, good examples of animal keepers that adapt this system are the Fulani, the Koyam, and the Shua. Extensive system is less expensive in terms of feeding, building, and equipment, but it requires a large area of land, and animals are exposed to diseases, parasites, predators, thieves, and harsh weather conditions. Intensive system. This entails keeping animals in a confined or enclosed area. It is characterized with high costs resulting from labor, feed, land, housing, and health management. In this system, animals are provided with quality feed, shelter, better medical care, and proper performance record of each animal is being kept. Semi-intensive system. This system was designed to take advantage of low cost of the extensive system and also the high productivity of the intensive system. Grazing with the animal is done daily using paid laborer in addition to concentrate feed, mineral salt, and clean water. Problems of livestock production in Nigeria. Number one, feed supply. Wide seasonal variation have an important influence on feed production. When there is high variation in feed supplies, particularly forages, marked fluctuations arise in the rate of weight gain of grazing animals, causing low productivity and poor quality animal products. Two, low animal nutrition leads to high susceptibility to diseases and parasites. This causes exceedingly high losses in animal productivity. Three, excess of animals can be supported by the environment. This is brought about largely because individual farmer and community or tribal groups do not relate their stock numbers according to available feed supplies. And so this results to the fact that the environment cannot support the excess of animals that we have. Four, much of the time, the prevailing temperature and humidity, they impose stresses on the animals. That means the climatic conditions, they impose stress on the animal. When this happens, the animals must expend extra energy if they are to maintain their thermal balance. And this also can result into a low output and also a decrease in the utilization of feed or the efficiency of feed energy. Number five, the programs for genetic improvement are few and this constitutes an important inhibitor to successful livestock enterprise. Six, incentives to animal production are often low for the majority of the livestock owners because of inadequate marketing organizations, including processing and storage facilities for providing reliable supplies of products to consumers and feed to producers. Seven, poor transportation is a serious deterrent to producer incentives. For example, after cattle has been traded a very long distance, sometimes up to 400 to 600 kilometers, there may be little profit from their sales because of weight, shrinkage. Other problems include those of insufficient capital for implementing innovations and also problems associated with land tenure. This can be a further inhibitor to potentially successful livestock enterprises, since many of the owners will have to graze their animals in lands other than their own. In conclusion, animal production is a traditional activity in all parts of Nigeria. It forms a significant component of most farming systems in the country, whether pastoral, agro-pastoral, or agricultural. Nigeria has a population of over 140 million sheep, 24.5 million goats, 7.6 million pigs, 19.6 million cattle, 126 million chicken. This is according to Food and Health Organization, UNA Agricultural Organization of 1997. The contribution of animal production to the national economy is multifaceted. The ruminant cattle animal, which involves the cattle, the buffalo, the sheep, goats, and camel, in addition, have a dual role of being important for utilizing natural grazing land and for combined crop or livestock farming, supplying animal power in many countries and by products of great value. The economic services rendered by the poultry species include the provision of poultry, meat, eggs, and feathers. The meat and the eggs are both nutritional and of economic importance. Thank you. From Department of Agri Education. Introduction.